everybody, welcome back to Let's Play Planetarian for Steam, the final part. Yes, we are going to get it done today, folks. I don't care if it takes 30 minutes, 40 minutes, even 50. We're gonna wrap up this story. I had absolutely no idea where I was. I was probably several meters from my starting point, but I didn't know anything other than that. One of my feet got snagged on something and I tumbled to the ground. My grenade launcher rolled from my hands. The inside of my mouth was cut and I could taste lukewarm blood spreading out from within. The Fiddler Crab let out a shriek. I collapsed on the ground as fragments of concrete and glass pelted my waterproof cloak like many tiny bullets. It had hit a building that was very close to me. All I could do was cover my head with my arms and endure it. A few large fragments hit me directly on my back. I could feel the warmth of blood soaking my undergarments and the crevices of my skin. So I too was breaking down in the midst of this rain. There was no pain. The only thing was that it was incredibly difficult to breathe. Any more than this, and I wouldn't be able to take a single step further. Even if my eyes were shut, it was easy to tell where the Fiddler Crab was just by the sound. The three remaining legs would not be strong enough to absorb the recoil of the LERC. Every single time it moved, it was destroying its own frame by itself. Every single time it moved, the outcry of warped metal and shredded carbon fiber resonated dissonantly in the air. These sounds were nothing other than its death agony. It's gone mad. I muttered as if someone else could hear my words. Just what had gone mad? Was it this battle mech, which had lost itself in anger that it was burying everything around it, including the city that it was supposed to protect, without regard to friend or foe? Or was it this sarcophagus city, which had ceased to function so long ago, and in which now only lived the rain and the memories of those who had once inhabited it? Or perhaps it was laughing. Beyond the rain-soaked wind, that out-of-order battle mech was laughing shrilly. All of the sounds were distorted and yet very distinctly audible. The Fiddler Crab stopped, and then assumed a firing stance. Even if its leg was broken, there was no way I would be able to get out of its sights now. Right, this time around it would definitely not miss its enemy. That is, unless it had a sliver of reason or mercy left in it. I tried to open my eyes. It was to see for myself the shape of death, and the death that I had been rewarded with. The Fiddler Crab had stopped moving. She was standing there in the middle of the buffer zone. At some point, she had flung off the waterproof cloak that I had given her. With a tender smile on her face, she stood before the gigantic battle mech. It was like a scene from an antique religious painting. Without any hesitation at all, she walked towards the Fiddler Crab. It was a calm, sure gait, like that one would display when one walked forth to greet an old friend. The Fiddler Crab appeared bewildered. It had disengaged from firing position and was scanning her with its civilian detection sensors. I forcibly slammed myself back into reality, trying to overcome my paralysis. I only had one chance to destroy it, and it was now. I found the grenade launcher that I had dropped in a puddle. I fumbled to crack open the barrel and finally managed to load it with my last AP cartridge. If I wanted to strike its armored upper surface from ground level, I would have no choice but to fire it at a high angle. I did not have the time to adjust my sights either. With my back still plastered to the mud, I eyeballed the distance to the gun turrets, and then pointed my grenade launcher at the sky. And then, in the span of several seconds, it all happened. The twin machine gun turrets slowly started to revolve, as if they had finally decided on something. She simply continued to walk toward the Fiddler Crab, step by step. I pressed the trigger. The Fiddler Crab's machine gun spat out flames. The 40mm canister arced through the threatening sky, trailing white fumes behind it. The line of 13mm machine gun rounds kicked up a path of water towards her like a murderous red serpent. The canister hit. I could see the Fiddler Crab's main cannon seeming to expand. The ammunition bay hatch blew asunder, letting smoke and leaping flames billow forth. The fiery serpent continued to track toward her delicate body as if to eat her alive. And then... oh, God. Her body, torn apart by the bullets, danced in the air like a bird. The rain continued to fall. The Fiddler Crab had fallen completely silent. As if it had returned to sanity at its last moment, it had swiveled so that the long barrel of its railgun was pointing toward the rift in the quarantine wall. However, that gun would never fire again. The ammunition inside the main armament had all been induced to explode, and black smoke was rising from the crevices of the armor plating. This was a sight that could be seen anywhere in this dead city. It was freezing cold, and my breath frosted white. The widely scattered wreckage was steaming in the rain. I walked forward, pulling my broken leg behind me and following the bullet marks in the ground, and finally arrived at where she lay. Lips opened and clearly called out to me. You can speak? I told you not to move until I returned. Why did you do such a stupid thing? And just as usual, she smiled. Her fingertips, dirtied by the mud, were gently trembling. Underneath fractures in her skin, a dark metallic frame was forlornly exposed. These were her words, and yet these were not her words.
暴走状態にある機体は現在機能を停止していると思われます。
This was an incantation totally unrelated to the will that had been sealed within the depths of our maiden memory.
該当する機体から速やかに離れ、最寄りの警察機関、もしくはサポートセンターにご連絡ください。
After she said all of this, she looked over at me once again and blinked as if she was relieved. She said that it was her honor. That the instinct that the human beings who had never cared about anything other than themselves had embedded into her was an honor.
お客様, おけがはございませんか? おけがはございませんか?
That was all I could manage. And again, she smiled.
お預かりした雨具と花束はあちらの歩道に置いてあります。この道を少しお戻りになればすぐに見つかると思います。
She turned her neck as if to show me the way. Her eyes caught the wreckage of the battle mech.
彼に代わって心より詫び申し上げます。きっと彼も壊れていたんだと思います。私たちロボットは人間の皆様の幸せのためにありますから、あのような乱暴なことは 本当はしたくなかったんだと思います。私には分かります。私も少しだけ壊れていますから。
I put my arm around her back just so I could hold her close. She shivered several times as if she was having convulsions. Everything below her chest had been torn asunder by machine gun fire. There was no way to put her back together now. So many precise parts were dispersed throughout the rain, similar to entrails made of metal. It seemed that if I tried to move her even just a little bit, she might never move again. I wanted to scream. I was just as broken as she was. There was still a squad of warmongers defending these ruins. Now that I had destroyed its vanguard, the remaining warmongers would be swarming toward this location. If I was going to escape, the time was now. But despite this, here I was, unable to leave this place.
バックアップ用電池が消耗しているので、その後は起動不能となります。メンテナンスコールを発信していますが、受講されません。サポートセンターは現在通信不能です。緊急用サテライトコールを発信していますが、中継衛星が見つかりません。
She said as if in jest, continuing to smile the same as ever. She was listening into the empty space with her antennas that were no longer of any use. She was calling for aid that would never come, no matter what. I found that I was unable to bear watching her do this. You don't have to call anyone. I'll save you. I'll repair you, so... Blue and white sparks flew as the rain hit the exposed machinery in her chest, now bereft of insulation or electricity. As if she were following my gaze, she said with embarrassment. Yet her tone and her facial expression seemed to be in the deepest agony. I already knew that the engineers who would be able to repair her, as well as the new enclosure that she wanted, and even those people who needed her, they were all things that had disappeared from this world so long ago. She smiled and looked up at the rain for some time. And then she turned to face me again. The sound of her vertebral motors echoed like bitter wheezing. She bent herself back quietly and then proudly showed me a nameplate glinting in the rain. The lenses installed in both her ears began emitting a faint light. This was the holographic videotape playback mechanism that she was so proud of. A spherical screen like a crystal globe coalesced around the breast of her crumbling uniform. Sorry about that. The focal axis of the lenses must have been skewed by the gunfire because I could see the projected images wavering and flickering.
Hoshino Yumemi desu.
Her voice flowed from a set of speakers close to her ears. I did a double take and focused as intently as I could on the image being displayed. There were a lot of people. The projection room was packed with people, and every chair in the room was filled. This scene was one that she had recorded through her own eyes. The entire projection room shook with the sound of applause. Next, a very young girl in a long skirt came up close. In her arms, she was holding a bouquet that was about as large as she was. The girl stood up on her tiptoes and then presented the bouquet.
Arigatou gozaimasu.
And then another thunderously hearty round of applause.
Watashi no shūnin shiki desu. 私の名前を考えてくださったんです。その中から館長さんとスタッフの皆さんが一つだけ選んでくれたんです。それが星野夢美です。私はとても気に入っています。他の1262人の方々がつけてくださった名前もとても気に入っています。
The spherical screen faded and the figure of the young girl vanished. As I frantically strained my eyes, I could see an even frailer scene starting to play. Two people were standing in front of her as if they were getting a souvenir photograph taken.
Yumemi-chan, kirei na hoshi o arigato. Kondo wa tomodachi minna de kuru kara, sore made genki de ne.
Next, a well-built male customer.
次は結婚記念日に妻を連れてきます。
That was all he said as he gently rubbed her head. And then an entire sequence of people appeared and vanished.
子供の頃のような素晴らしい星空でした。来年の今日にもきっとロボットさんに会いに来ますね。
星のことがいろいろ分かって面白かったです。夏休みの自由研究にはゆめみちゃんのことを書こうと思います。
めちゃめちゃ綺麗で、すっごく感動しました。絶対また来ます。
子供が途中で泣いちゃってごめんなさいね。ほら、ロボットのお姉さんにごめんなさいわ。
ゆめみちゃん、
every single person had words of thanks and a kind smile for her. Every single person promised from the bottom of his or her heart that they would definitely come again.
ありがとうございます。またのお越しを心よりお待ちしています。
No matter how old or of which sex the customer was, she invariably responded thus and bowed deeply.That is why this particular projection ended with a close-up view of the floor. These were all her precious, precious memories. They were all maddening visions of a time when the world was still moving in the right direction, when people were still reaching out toward the stars. Again, the image wavered and then shifted into a completely different way.The background was the reception area of the planetarium. It seemed like she was bending over a little. She was engaging two small silhouettes at their level.
お父さんとお母さんの星はどこ?
The silhouette seeming like a young girl was looking intently into the camera.
お尋ねの星の正式な名前か座標はお分かりになりますか?お父さんとお母さんの星。
The girl fell silent at that.
お父さんとお母さんの星はまだ新しいから、ゆめみちゃんも知らないんだよ。
The other and slightly larger silhouette answered from the other side.This would have to have been a little girl and her big brother.
Yumemi-chan, そうだよね。
はい。超新星や彗星などが出現した場合は、私のデータベースにはすぐには反映されない場合があります。誠に申し訳ありません。
She again bowed politely.
あのね、お父さんとお母さんは、マレネタリクスで働いてるんだよ。
マレネクタリスだよ。ネタリクスじゃなくて。
そうですか。とても立派なお仕事ですね。
この前の事故で二人とも死んじゃったんだけど。
The big brother fell silent with that. I wanted to reach out my hands to them, but my body wouldn't move. The feeling was maddening. For I knew full well. These were images captured during a summer 30 years ago. Within that hologram, the big brother and little sister were still unaware of the true nature of the tragedy that had befallen them. The military invasion of the moon's second port at Mar Nectaris was first announced to the public as a problem with the power reactor. Thousands of people had vanished just like that, and the government concealed the truth with an iron grasp over the media. But even that was nothing more than a prologue for what was to come. Not 1 month after that, war began to ravage the entire Earth.
あのね、あのね、 お父さんとお母さんはお星様になったんだよ。 だから、お兄ちゃんとここに見に来たの。
そうなんですか。 今日はご満足いただけましたか？
うん、とっても綺麗だ。
いつでも見に来てくださいね。 イエナさんはとても素晴らしい性能ですから、 いつでも綺麗な星をお見せできます。 お父さんとお母さんの星につきましても、 きちんと調べておきますので。
うん、この次はおじさんに行って、 ちゃんとお金もらってくる。
お待ちしています。
A clicking sound came from her right ear. The brother and sister rippled like water and vanished, and a different image came into focus. It was the projection room. You could see the silhouette of the projector slanting diagonally in the midst of a dim background. Five, maybe six adults standing around her. Everyone was holding something in his or her hand. It was obvious that those were the rough gas masks that were in general use during pre-war days.
館長さん、 ただいまイエナさんに異常があるようです。
Her voice said.
南天および北天の恒星電球が取り付けられていません。 次回の投影まであと22分ですので、 早急な対処が必要と考えます。
大丈夫だよ、ユメミ。 何も心配することはない。
The silhouette that was standing directly in front of her, perhaps a middle-aged man, replied thus. But it wasn't a voice that made it seem as if he was trying to tell himself the same thing.
ユメミちゃん、
Another voice said. A young woman's voice, it seemed.
私たちね、 しばらくみんなで旅行に行くことになったの。
はい、ご旅行ですか。 それは素晴らしいですね。
それでね、 ゆめみちゃんには留守番をお願いしたいの。 私たちが帰ってくるまでここで待っていてほしいの。
Even from the small tiny speakers of the holovid player, I could tell that the young woman's voice was shaking.
わかりました。 皆さんがお戻りになるのはいつでしょう。
She asked, her response not having changed at all from its usual routine. After a short silence, another voice answered her.
まだわからないの。
The image became very slightly slanted. She was cocking her head in doubt as she would usually do in such circumstances.
それでは、皆さんの休暇は無期限ということですか？
そうね。 長くなるかもしれないし、すぐに帰ってくるかもしれない。
ご旅行先はどちらでしょう。きっと、とても楽しいところなのですね。
She probably had that same warm smile on her face as she said this. As if to represent all the members of the staff who had fallen silent, that man that she called Mr. Manager now opened his mouth.
いいかい、ユメミ。私たちは必ず戻ってくる。誰一人欠けることなく、必ずここに戻ってくる。その時はまた一緒に働いてくれ。
はい、艦長さん。
She answered clearly.
ユメミちゃん、またね。
またな、ユメミ。
必ずまた会えるから、待っててね、ユメミ。
This employee flung her mess to the ground and swept up the robot in an embrace.
こんなのおかしいよ。間違ってる。間違ってるよ。だって、置いていけないよ。ユメミちゃんを置いていくなんて。そんなの、そんなのできるわけないよ。だってユメミちゃん、私たちの仲間だよ。友達だよ。私たちの中で一番働き者なんだよ。私たちとユメミちゃん、何にも違わないよ。ユメミちゃん、こんなところ置いてけるわけないよ。
私はロボットです。私には休暇は必要ありません。ですが、皆さんには休暇は必要だと考えます。
ユメミちゃん。
The girl broke down crying at that point, tears streaming down her face.
ごめんね、ユメミちゃん。こんなところに一人ぼっちで、ごめんね。
She broke into a voice filled with so much lament that it was as if her body entire would burst asunder from the strain. That feeling propagated outwards and swept all the members of the staff into itself. Understandable.This hologram must have been recorded immediately after the germ bomb bombardment of the major cities of the world. They would now have to flee from this city with just the clothing on their backs and nothing else. They were not permitted to bring any equipment at all along with them.
皆さんはなぜお泣きになっているのでしょう。私はまた何か粗相をしましたでしょうか。重大な間違いをしましたでしょうか。だとしたら、本当に本当に申し訳ありません。
ユメミちゃん、違うの。違う。ただね。
Another somewhat calmer voice, I'll bet one still filled with tears, answered.
一緒に行けたらいいのに。ユメミちゃんと一緒に行けたらきっと楽しいのになって、そんな風にね。
And then in the same fashion as the other staff member, his voice also grew choked with tears.
私のことでしたらどうぞお気遣いなく。
She answered brightly as if nothing had changed from usual at all.
私はいつまでも待てますから。イエナさんと一緒にいつまでも待てますから。どうぞ留守は私にお任せください。 粗相のないように一生懸命頑張ります。皆さん、どうぞ楽しいご旅行を。
Existence which had been created by men for the service of men and men alone. listen closely. To tell you the truth, I came to get you.
To申しますと?
As she inclined her head just a little bit in her usual doubt.
あの壁の向こうにな.
Beyond that,
新しい職場がある.
Beyond that wall lies your new workplace. Pointed my finger at the looming quarantine wall. Out at the uninhibited, submerged wasteland that lay beyond the quarantine wall. Your partner projector, as well as your colleagues, are all waiting there. Customers are packed into a full house waiting for you. Everyone is awaiting your commentary with great anticipation. You'll be working there from this day forth. You'll be able to work at what you want to forevermore. She did not reply at all. As if she were gathering the last of her power, she narrowed her eyes slightly and stared out at where I was pointing. And then she whispered, attentively and calmly, she again lapsed into silence. Her artificial pupils trembled slightly as if she were gazing at something beyond behind me.
いつまでも人間の皆
様の。
わかった。
I understand.
俺が届けてやる。
I'll take you there. I answered. She fell silent for a short time. Each second of which was an eternity. Sockets were overflowing with the downpour, and raining streaks of water were flowing incessantly from the corners of her eyes. It was almost as if she was really was crying.
日はお客様がたくさん来てくれます。いつもお客様がいてもいいよ。全力大勢で今回しなければね。
arms open as if to speak again. And then something akin to a smile floated up to her device. And she stopped moving. She was looking up at the rain that she loved so much. She was staring so happily up at it, as if she would never in all eternity tire of it. The freezing cold rain was falling. I gently brushed her wet hair aside with my fingertips to search around her ears. The slot had been unlocked and the plastic memory card was sticking out, waiting for me to take it. She had probably released the card at her last moment. I gently pulled the memory card out of its slot. And then, I lay her body down on the mud. The memory card was about the size of a cigarette pack and was slightly warm. That warmth evaporated away slowly in the middle of my hands. I retrieved my waterproof cigarette case from inside my cloak. I put the memory card inside and sealed it tight. Through the gaps in the rain, I could hear treads and mechanized feet coming in my direction. This was the sound of the hunter-killer warmongers. I looked up at the sky that was stormy without end. And then I dropped my grenade launcher into a puddle. I would not need such a thing, not where I was going. The rain was still falling, even now. Her heart was secure next to mine. I began to walk. Where were the stars now? Where would I have to go in order to see them? I walked forth into this fractured world, yet my thoughts were forever on the sky. Folks, you just witnessed history today with this LP. First time I've ever cried on camera. You've heard me laugh, you've heard me rage, and now you've heard me cry. I think you've seen virtually every dimension of TK. Planetarian did what Katawa Shoujo couldn't. That's the power of Ki, my friends. Anyways, I hope you all enjoyed Planetarian for Steam. Damn near an hour this part went, surprise, but hey, it was totally worth it for this. An exceptional visual novel. I love you, Yumemi. I have her as my wallpaper right now as I'm talking to you guys. Anyways, I certainly hope you all enjoyed this LP. Hopefully you guys aren't crying as hard as I am right now. Anyway, stay tuned for my next Let's Play, which will probably be a wrestling game. So we'll get some nice action in. I'm gonna do WCW NWO Revenge for the 64, so I'll have to get the emulator for that. Anyway, stay tuned for that one, and I'll see you all later. Peace friggin' out, all.